Today is all about the scent of disappointment. Stay tuned and find out all about it. Always waiting for someone to make me happy, pick me up. I realize that someone is me, but you call life that ain't living. No, that's the child that's got a phone. Yeah, my season now, I stand alone. Just thought that I would let you know that something you just can't control. No,
should I wear my hair in a ponytail? Should I dress myself up in Chanel? Do I measure me by what you think? Absolutely not.
Absolutely not.
Should I go to work in a miniskirt? Am I giving you the right to flirt? I won't compromise my point.
Taylor of Old Bond Street is a house that was created in 1854. And the creator of the house was Jeremiah Taylor. And it grew over the years, moved from Bond Street to German Street, to German Street, and is very famous for their shaving products and noted for their beginnings in botanical extracts. And it's quite a revered house. So when I heard about this one fragrance that looked really interesting to me, it's called, it's from the St. James collection and it's called Luxury. I was fascinated by the color. I thought that was a really interesting color. And I'd never had anything from the House of Taylor of Old Bond Street. And I have been been exploring British houses of historical note, like Atkinson's, which began in the 1700s and was revived just about 5 or 6 years ago, and Flora's, and houses like that. So I thought I would try this and explore it. And it is definitely a disappointing blind buy. I have been very lucky in my blind buys in the past. Most of the blind buys I've purchased have been good to exceptional. I don't think I've been this disappointed since Zinzani, which was really, really a disappointment. I was expecting something really wonderful from that, and well, I didn't even do a review on that. It was so bad, and I rarely do bad reviews, but I was asked by one of my subscribers, Kevin McCoy, who I have a little correspondence with, and we sometimes talk privately about fragrances, and he always lets me in on what his scent of the day is and wonderful fragrances that he's getting in the mail. And I just want to take this moment to say thank you, Kevin, for all of your support. And so this review is for him. He bought this and didn't like it either and offered to send it to me. But the funny thing was, we both bought it at around the same time. So, on with the review. I have to say that when you spray it on paper, it is a lot more promising than on the skin. It is labeled as an aromatic fougere, and in comparison to other aromatic fougeres that I do love, I don't know where that's coming from. I just don't know where that's coming from. It's supposed to be having the accords of aromatic citrus, fresh, spicy, green, and marine. Maybe that's what's throwing it off, is the marine notes. I'm not a big fan of marine notes. It has ocean or a sea note in it. Speaking of the notes, they are top notes of bergamot, C notes, mandarin, and lemon. The mid notes are fruity geranium, lavender, and coriander, and a touch of mint. And the base notes are amber, patchouli, and pine tree. So, back to on paper, it's minty and it's kind of sweet. But there is this metallic blandness that comes up almost immediately. And on my skin, even more so. It's a kind of the kind of metallic note that bothers me in Sauvage, in Dior Sauvage. It is very I hate to say this. I mean, the house has got a great history, and it's hard to do a review like this about a house that I know very little about. And I want to say right here that I'm going to be trying some other fragrances by them, but it's cheap. It just smells cheap, inexpensive, overly synthetic, and kind of just aimed at the lowest denominator of the kind of nose attraction that you could possibly aim for. It just is very, very middle of the road and ordinary and disappointing, I'm sorry to say. But I'm sure the house has some wonderful fragrances, and Kevin even mentioned that their sandalwood is exceptional. So I'm definitely going to try that. It isn't expensive, so I didn't waste too much money, but this one is definitely going to not even be gifted, but I'm afraid it's not even good enough to use as a room deodorizer. Mm-mm, no. So there you have one of my, what's going to make me sneeze? No, I'm okay. There you have one of my few not so happy reviews, not so positive reviews on Taylor of Old Bond Street, the St. James Collection Luxury. I couldn't even find a nose on it, the creator of it. So anyway, out with that and in with something wonderful later on. This is Lander Smith from Sense Memory saying, remember, wear what you love and not what they say you should like. And not something so cheap and awful. No, I'm going to stop there.